morning students. For this session we are going to learn about the answer in detail. So we have 7 detailed questions for matter around us. So first question, differentiate metals and non-metals. So metals and non-metal, first point, metals are lesser, they have a shiny surface. Metals have lesser, they are shiny surface. So non-metal is directly opposite. Non-metals are non-lesser, so they have non-shiny surface, that is dull surface. So metals are lesser, non-metals are non-lesser. They are shining, they are not shining. Second point, metals are generally hard. Metals are generally hard. Non-metals are generally soft. Third point, the metals, most of the metals are bendable. That means malleability. It can be converted into sheet. When we hammer the metal is expanded or converted into sheet, that is called bendable or malleable. So non-metals are non-bendable, we cannot convert it into sheet. So non-bendable or non-malleable. Next point, most of the metals can be bent, beaten into sheet, and they cannot drawn in, they can drawn into wire. That is, that property is called ductility. The most of the metal can be beaten into sheet and they can drawn into wire. So metals are have ductility. Non-metals are non-ductility. You cannot convert it into wire. Next point, most metals are good conductor of electricity. Most of the metals are good conductor of electricity. So non-metals, bad conductor of electricity. Metals are good conductor of electricity, non-metals are bad conductor of the electricity. Heat, so most of the metals are good conductor of heat, non-metals are bad conductor of the heat. So electricity and heat, so metals are good conductor of heat and electricity, non-metals are bad conductor of heat and electricity. Last point, most metals are making ringing sound when stuck, hence they are used to make object like bells. That property is known as sonorous means making sound. So when the metals are stuck with any other object, it produces a sound, ringing sound. So that's why we are used for making bells and gongs. So it producing sound. Non-metals are do not make any sound. So non-sonorous. When we are stuck the non-metals with any object, cannot produce the sound. So non-sonorous. So these are the difference. These are the points of difference between metals and non-metals. So next question, explain the characteristics of compound. A compound is formed only when the constituent elements combine in a fixed ratio. A compound is formed only when the constituent element combine in fixed ratio. So elements, mostly the elements combined in fixed ratio. So most the compound is formed only when the constituent elements combined in fixed proportion. For example, we know that water H2O, so two hydrogen chemically combined in one oxygen. So the ratio is fixed for all the state, solid, liquid or gas. So the compounds is formed only when constituent elements combined in fixed ratio, proportion or ratio. Next point, the property of the compounds are different from those of its constituent element. The property of the compounds are different from those constituent elements. For example, you have to take the water. So what is the formula for water? H2. So hydrogen and oxygen exist in air. So hydrogen is a, what is the state? Gaseous state. And oxygen also exists in gaseous state in atmosphere. But this oxygen and hydrogen chemically combined. So they both are chemically combined, they formed as a compound water. What is the state of water? Is liquid. So the property of water is liquid. The hydrogen and oxygen, they are in individual element, they have the different property. They are gaseous state. Hydrogen and oxygen are gaseous state. For example, another example, sodium chloride. You know that sodium is a metal and chlorine is a non-metal. So chlorine is a poisonous gas and sodium is a mild explosive metals. So both are have the different property, we cannot consume. But the sodium and the chlorine are chemically combined. They formed as a sodium chloride compound. We are using as a common salt. So it is for consuming our human beings. So the property of sodium and chlorine is entirely different from sodium chloride. So that is the second point. The property of the compounds are different from those of constituent elements. A compounds cannot be broken down by a physical method like filtration. Sedimentation is a physical method. We cannot separate it, broke down the individual elements. Because the compounds made up of different elements chemically combined. So sodium chloride cannot be separated by a physical method such as filtration. Sodium chloride we cannot filter. We cannot separate sodium and chlorine. A compound can be separated into constituent element by a chemical method. We are doing chemical method. Only we have to separate the elements from the compound. Physical method we cannot separate. Chemical method only we have to separate the constituent elements in a compound. So these are the characteristics of compound or properties of the compound. Next, third question. Describe the different way in which we can write the symbols of element, give the appropriate example. So what are the rules? First one, the chemical symbol usually consists of one or two letter. The symbols are, chemical symbols are usually consist of one or two letter. The symbol of most element corresponding, most of the element is corresponding to the first letter. First letter is capitalized, capital letter of the English name. For example, the symbol for oxygen is O and that for the hydrogen is H. So first letter oxygen, first letter O, so capital O, and hydrogen is capital H. So element represented by the single letter symbols. What are the elements in a single letter? Hydrogen symbol H, single letter. Fluorine capital F, first letter. Oxygen capital O, first letter. Carbon first letter capital C. Phosphorus first letter capital P. Sulfur capital S. Potassium K. Uranium U. These are the elements represented a single letter symbol. Next, when there is more than one element begins with the same letter, more than one element begins with the same letter, that the symbols are taken the two letters, then only they have to take the two letters. So the first letter is capitalized while the second letter has been lowercase. First letter is capital letter, second letter is small letter. For example, the name of both hydrogen and helium, both are begins with the letter H. So that's why the hydrogen already we put the symbol H. So helium begins with H. So we have to take the next letter E, small letter HE, helium. Similarly, the symbol of carbon. So already carbon is a single letter, capital C. While the symbol for calcium, chlorine, chromium, you know that calcium, first two letters CA, chlorine, first letter and third letter CL, chromium, first two letters, first letter and third letter CR. So calcium for CA, chlorine CL, chromium CR. So the element represented by a symbol for two letters. So what are the elements? Aluminium, first two letter AL. Argon, first two letter AR. Arsenic, first letter and third letter AS. Barium, first two letter BA. Nickel, first two letter NI. Bromine, first two letter B, capital B and small r. Chromium, first letter and third letter CR. Cobalt, first two letters capital C, small o. Helium, capital H, small e, HE. Magnesium, first letter and third letter capital M, small g. Calcium, first two letters CA. Chlorine, first letter and third letters capital C, small l. The symbols for the sum of the elements are derived from Latin names. Already we discussed in short answer also. So again we have to explain the some examples of Latin name. So symbol for gold, AU. So what is the Latin name for gold? Aurum. AURUMRM. So that's why they are given the symbol AU. Similarly, symbol for copper is CU. What is the Latin name? Cuprum, CU. CUPRUM. So first two letters CU. So from the list, copper, Latin name is cuprum, so symbol is CU. Cuprum, first two letter capital C, small u. Lead. What is the Latin name for lead? Plumbum. So first letter and fourth letter P, capital P, small b. Potassium, Latin name is gallium, so capital K. Iron, ferrum, first two letter capital F, small e, ferrum, so Fe. Mercury, hydrogyrum, so capital H and G, gyrum. Hydra, capital H, from gyra, G, so small g, so HG. Sodium, so natrium, so Na, first two letter capital N, small a, so Na. So fourth detail, difference between element and compound. Difference between element and compound. Elements. The element is the simplest substance. Element is a simplest substance. Compound is a chemical substance formed by combination of two or more elements. Element is a simplest substance compound. Compound is a chemical substance formed by combining two or more elements. Elements combine to form compound. Compound can be split into element. Compound can broke down into elements. So from elements, atoms are the fundamental particle of elements. Atoms are the fundamental particle of elements. Compound. Molecules are the fundamental particle of a compound. Here atom is a fundamental particle of element. In compound, molecules is a fundamental particle of a compound. So element is a simplest substance. Element combined to form a compound. Atom are fundamental particle of elements. In compound, compounds is a chemical substance formed by combination of two or more elements. Compound can be split into elements. The molecule are the fundamental particle of a compound. Question number 5. Write any 5 characteristics of compound. So this question already we discussed. The question number 2 also the same question. And the question number 6. List comparative property of metal and non-metals. Give the 3 examples of each. So this is also already we have discussed. This is difference between metal and non-metal. So both are 5 and 6 are already we discussed. So same answer you have to write, 5 and 6. So next 7th question, the last question we take. Write down the property of metalloids. First we know that metalloid, what is metalloid? Metalloids means it exists the both the characteristics of metal as well as non-metal. So some of the metals have both metal character as well as non-metal character, so they are called as metalloids. So what is the property of metalloids? Metalloids usually look like a metal but behave largely like non-metals. The first one, metalloids usually look like metals, behave like non-metals. So they are shiny, brittle, solid with intermediate electrical conductivity. They are shiny, brittle, solid with intermediate electrical conductivity. So in between metals and non, the conductivity is medium. So they can form alloys with metal. Alloys means mixture of two or more metals. So metalloids mixed with metal, they formed as alloys. And they are semiconductors. Metalloids used as a semiconductors. Semiconductors used for computer electronic chipsets. So electronic device, it is used in electronic devices, semiconductors. Metalloids are solid at room temperature. So what are the property? Metalloids are usually look like metal but behave like largely like non-metal. They are shiny, brittle, solid with intermediate electrical conductivity. They form alloys with metal. They are semiconductors. Metalloids are solid at room temperature. Thank you, students.